although went completely new in the auction, just retained Akshar Patel, got a couple of their older players back in Miller, had a new captain. Their performance, I think it would be a bit disappointing after their start, having won 5 out of the first 6, in spite of maybe not having the strongest squad on paper. They put themselves in a great position to qualify for the playoffs. Unfortunately, just dropped off in form pretty quickly. I'm always of the opinion that an Indian captain is good for a IPL team. Ashwin, having been around, you know, played at CSK, one of the more successful teams, obviously must have learnt a lot. Looked quite at home with leading the Kings 11 team. There were, if you had to be critical, there were certain decisions that maybe he overthought at times. In terms of sending Akshar Patel ahead of a Yuvraj Singh or a Tiwari in one of the games, but those were far and few in between. In general, Ashwin's tactically and strategy-wise, he's been pretty spot on. It's unfortunate that the team's not been good enough performance-wise to back those up. The big ticket players, especially Rahul and Andrew Tai, I mean, those two have done more than enough or done more than justice to the faith that the owners or the franchise showed in them with spending the amount of money they did. I mean, Rahul, for most of the season, carried the batting single-handedly, and so did Tai. And Mujib was the performer as well with him. But Andrew Tai, you know, for a fast bowler to come and do well in Indian conditions is never easy. So those two were successes for Kings 11. And on the flip side, Akshar Patel, someone who was retained by Kings 11, probably didn't do enough for a guy who's been retained and the franchisees shown so much faith in you, along with Finch, arrived a couple of games late into the tournament, and in spite of all that confidence shown in him by the team management, just couldn't win any games for them. A couple other veterans who Kings 11 obviously took a gamble on at their base price very late into the auction, Chris Gayle and Yuvraj Singh. I mean, Yuvraj Singh had another tough season in the IPL. And could find it very difficult going forward next year if Kings 11 retain him or not. It's going to be very difficult with Chris Gayle again. Looked like he was a lot fitter, Chris Gayle, when he played those first two or three games and played a couple of cracking innings and just seemed to have petered out as the tournament progressed. Whether, again, that's a big call for the Kings 11 to make for next year, whether he's going to be good enough for them to have in the entire tournament, because that's how you would look at a player and not by just one or two innings that he plays. I mean, pretty obvious the breakthrough player this year has been Mujib. I mean, again, another Afghan coming and making an impression, and not just making an impression, making such a huge impact, and a bowler at that too. To play an overseas spinner is always a tricky decision for most teams, but he showed us enough in this season why he's going to be along the lines of a Rashid Khan or a Sunil Narayan, who is going to be one of the mainstays of any team that he's part of in the IPL because of how impactful he is. So he's clearly the breakthrough player. Another promising player that we've seen for Kings 11 is Rajput. I think seems to have all the necessary things a fast bowler needs, especially with the new ball, swings the new ball, has a little bit of pace and bounce, and hopefully with this experience this season can get better for them and become a mainstay, because he's clearly got a lot more than some of the other pacers in the team.